So you've had TED Talks and Tammy Talks. This is a Tito Talk here. So so I'm Raul Gaston. I'm the principal at Jefferson Middle School in Villa Park in District 45. Today I want to talk to you a little bit about translations and education. I will walk you through the importance of translation and equity, the translation do's that I recommend that you might want to follow, the material pitfalls that are you can watch out for, the assessment inequities that actually do exist, and then close it all up to finalize. So let's start with clear communication. Without clear communication, learning is hindered. It's even impossible at times. A prime example is a well-documented case of Helen Keller. Without clear communication, and you wouldn't be able to have any education at all. It goes without saying that if I understand what you tell me, I am able to respond. In other words, I can engage in the task of learning if we are able to communicate. Translations not only opens the lines of communication, but also can create a sense of welcome. This is the case for both students and parents. Just the fact that you tried to use my language makes me feel valued. Clear communication and engagement and welcoming environment start allowing for equity to be more possible for other language families. Equity is a big buzzword in education today. We've all heard it. However, equity is much wider and deeper than many think. Now let's look at some translation do's. Number one, give your translators time. If it took you 15 minutes to write it, it'll take them twice as long to translate it. If you're doing some oral translation, one sentence at a time, please. Use common vocabulary. Stay away from school lingo or acronyms. Words like homeroom or acronyms such as PBIS or IEP don't translate well without some added explanation. Number three, avoid bouncing between synonyms. Decide if you will use the word student or child, educator or teacher, exam or test. These may seem like small things, but confusion is common when synonym bouncing occurs. Number four, use those electronic translators. You heard me right. No, they're not perfect, but they are improving in quality. However, they lose accuracy when you use school lingo, localisms, acronyms, and don't even bother translating a joke. It's horrible. My wife is a first grade teacher, and she shared with me this following example from a book that she uses. The book reads in English, "I like to bike after school," simple enough, and in Spanish, "Me gusta andar en bicicleta después de la escuela," pretty simple. That's a word count of just 6 compared to 9, no big deal, right? A word count of 6 versus 9 may not be a big deal, but look at the syllable count of 7 versus 17 syllables in the same passage. If the second language learners we know that there are more highly represented in SPED and retention rates. Could the language that we're using and text that we're using be a part of that problem? When we look at sounds, English can focus on 4 of 20 sounds and 7 syllables, and Spanish has to focus on 4 out of 5 sounds and 17 syllables. While translating may be good for communication, it can produce unintentional inequities in a student's material. You can also see that the level was a B for both languages, but later was changed to a level C in Spanish. We must continue to provide this feedback to our publishers. These inequities also exist in assessments we all use. Common national assessments and use words and language that is neither common nor correct at grade level. As a comparison, imagine a student that is given an English exam using words like rubbish. How would that kid feel? Yeah, there he is. Most assessment publishers just translate their materials and pay very little attention to the reading level. They don't consider the audience. This means that you must be that gatekeeper. Start asking questions. As the gatekeeper, principals can start looking for clues. If the Spanish passage is considerably longer or the syllable count is vastly different, your second language students may be having to read at a much higher level. If any group of students is asked to perform at a higher level than their general counterparts, it may lead to over-identification in SPED or retention rates. Be the principal that speaks up for them. So I close by asking you to be that informed administrator and start asking one simple question. Is this translated or authentic? If it's translated, start a simple task. Count the syllables. Thank you.